Okay, guys, how are you doing? This is Shocks here, Shocks Capital FX YouTube channel. Welcome back. And if you're new here, guys, we talk about BTMM, which is what we are going to talk about today. We talk about ICT, institutional order flow, everything you need to know about institutional trading. This is the channel, and you might as well subscribe and turn on your post notifications so that you don't miss any video from this channel every time we do upload this video. So today, guys, we are going to talk about H1 level count, right? We're going to be talking about H1 levels. So there are many ways to count levels, but the one I'm going to be showing you here is the easiest, the perfect one, yeah, to me, the accurate one, it's the accurate way of counting what, of counting levels. So how do we actually count levels? You know, there are many ways. Number one, there is some way you by using moving averages. Then there is many ways. So today I'm just going to show you the easiest one and the one you should be knowing, which is counting the days of rise and days of fall. So it's a cycle. So when price moves down, it moves up. When it moves up, it moves down. What goes up goes down. What goes down goes up. Okay, so this is how it goes. It's something like this. It's something like this. It's something like this. Yes, we start with a peak formation, but the peak formation is to be preceded by three levels or 3 days of rise or fall. So this is our peak formation right here. Let me just draw it as a background, this red one. So this is our peak, what, peak formation low, as you can see. So this is our peak formation low. So a peak formation low or a peak formation is validated by three levels of rise or fall. So what are the three levels? You see, there is, from this day, this is 18 March, we have 1 day of fall, this one, where then we have day 2 or 4 from this point to this point right here. This is a day of fall. Then the other day is from this point to this point. This is the third day of what, of fall. So we are counting these as what, as three levels. This is just a retracement to where this started. So we're not counting this, we just count this and this as one level, then this one as the third level. Then after level three, we go into what, into a peak formation low. So what we are doing here is the second or the next wave of levels is going to mirror the first wave of what, of levels. So if we put our vertical marker right here, we're saying these levels are going to be mirrored on the other side of the what, of the levels. So this was level three, as you can see, this was level three. So level three becomes level one, level two is still level two, level one becomes level three on the other side. So we're just flipping the what, the image on the left side to the right side, and those are your levels. So after you identify your peak, you wait for level one rise, then we wait for all the break of structure, everything, to confirm your what, to confirm your direction. After that, you wait for your entry at the mitigation block, at the breaker, at the what, at the order block, and you see how price goes. So as you can see, we have level one drop, level two drop, and level three drop. Then after that, we have peak formation low, then level one. After level one, we have a consolidation, sorry, we have a retracement back toward to the mitigation one, to the mitigation block, as you can see. So this is the mitigation block, this is the mitigation block, as you can see right here. So price comes back to the mitigation block, retests it, and goes for level what, for level two. So this is day one of rise, and this is day two of what, of rise. This was all consolidation, there was no rise here, there was just consolidation. Price was consolidating here. If you don't know how to spot consolidations, check out our video on trading consolidations on this channel. You understand why I said that is a consolidation and you are not counting it as a level. So what are we counting? We're counting this day of rise and this third day of rise. So after the third day, our levels are complete, and after this, we have a break of structure, then we have a retracement back for level two to what, to commence and go up. Then after that, we have price going down again, retests an order block and goes up. So this is how you actually spot your levels. First of all, identify the what? You identify the peak formation. So it can be a peak formation low like in this area, or a peak formation high where you are having price making a peak on the upside. So this is another example. We are seeing price coming back and forming what call a peak formation right here. So this is a single leg peak where we are having price just forming a V bottom or a V top. So these types of peaks, you don't have to trade them right away. You wait for break of structure and wait for a retest of an order block and go up. So which are the three levels which are validating this V bottom peak? We have one level, which is one day of drop, then another day of drop, another day of drop. So these are three levels, and this is our peak. And after the peak, level three becomes level one, level two, level two, level one becomes level three. So this is level one, level two, level three, and we also have a peak that side. Then we have this level three, this level one. You see the similarities between this move and that move. So that is what you are trying to do when you are counting your levels, and this is exactly the way you want to be counting your levels. So look at this, we have 1 day of drop, we have consolidation. So you don't count consolidation, you just count days of drop. So that is consolidation. Okay, this is level two and this is level three, then a peak formation low. After that we have level one, level two and level three. This is all consolidation and you don't count it level three, and you hit our quarter point. As you can see, that is 152.5, that's a 0.5 area, this is a 0.0 area, and you see price just went through it. And this is the cycle we are trying to understand, and this is the peak formation low which you first identify before everything else. After peak formation low, just count the levels. You have to see it being preceded by three levels for you to validate anything that you are going to do with that peak formation low. And after that, you see break of structure, return to order blocks, break of structure, return to order blocks. That's your move, and that's what you are looking for, right guys? Yeah. So let's look at our last example. So this is, so let's say this is the peak formation, right? Peak formation low, this one. Why are we saying that it's preceded by 3 days of four? 1, 2, 3 days of what? Of four. Then after that we see price going up level one, level two, level three, and after level three it forms another peak formation, what? Peak formation high. So this is a peak formation high. What happens at the peak? You see price dropping. So level three is being mirrored as level one, level two still remains as what? As level two. Level one, this one is now level what? Level three. So how do you trade these levels? You are just waiting for a break of structure like that, a break of structure. So levels is another way of looking at market structure. Do you understand? So a break of structure. What else do you see? You see return to order block, break of structure, return to order block, break of structure, return to order block, and so on and so on. So level one, sorry, so we have here, we have level one, level two and level three. What are we waiting for? We're just waiting for price to make its way back to the order block so it can make its way here or here. So we're just waiting to see how price does, and then we will trade our levels. Okay guys, so this is all about levels on H1. So just to summarize what we've been saying, we said on levels you are looking for days of rise or fall. So 1 day of rise is equivalent to one level, right? So if price falls for 1 day, that is one level, and if price rises for 1 day, that is one level. So if price doesn't move or price just consolidates for a day, that is consolidation, and you are not counting consolidation as a level. Levels have to be aggressive moves in one direction, aggressive falls, aggressive rises, considering you are looking at a single day or a single week if you're on H4, or a single month if you are on D1. So it all depends on what time frame you are looking for. So the H1 consider days of form and days of rises. So as you can see, we have 1 day of rise, 2 days of rise, 3 days, and the rises. Guys, you don't have to ask yourself if this is a rise. The moment you ask yourself if this is a rise or not, just know it's not a rise. Because if it is a rise or a fall or it's a move that you want to consider as a level, you don't have to ask yourself. You have to see it. If you don't see it, it's not there. If you don't see it, it's not there. Right? If you don't see it, it's not there, guys. It's not there. So guys, I hope you got something. I hope you got something, and trade what you see. This is me and this is my view on levels. Trade what you see. I'm sure Xander, I'm out.